Hello students, let us start with the second exercise of set theory. First of all, a few definitions before the start of this exercise. Some categories or some types of set are there. First is empty set. The set having no element is known as empty set. You can write example x such that x is a married bachelor. Or you can write x greater than 5 and x less than 0. Basically, one number is greater than 5 and second number is a negative number. It's not possible. That's why answer is empty. And you can represent this set by a symbol phi. Second type of set is singleton set. Actually, it came from the word single. Single means having one element. The set having only one element is known as singleton set. X is a prime minister of the country. It's a single. X such that x is natural number and x greater than 5, x less than 7, it's number 6. In this way you can represent singleton set. Third category is finite. What is the meaning of finite? Basically, if you count the number of elements of the set, then it is called finite. You can give any example. Then fourth category is infinite set. What is the meaning of infinite? If they are up to infinity or you can't count the number of elements of the set, then it is called infinite. What are equal sets? Two sets are said to be equal. The first set is equal to first and second is equal to second and third is equal to third. They are said to be equal sets. Sixth category is equivalent set. Equivalent sets are those sets in which the number of elements of the set are same. None other than that. Now let us start with the exercise 1.2. Which of the following are examples of null set? First is set of odd natural numbers divisible by 2. It is null set because there is no such type of odd number which is divisible by 2. Set of even prime numbers, it's 2. It is not a null set. Number less than 5 and greater than 7, there is no such type of number which is less than 5 and greater than 7, that's why answer is 5. It's a point common to parallel lines. There basically parallel lines never meet, that's why there is no point common to these lines, that's why answer is 5. In the second question, you have to identify finite or infinite sets. Set of months of year, it's finite, you can count. 1, 2, 3 up to so on. If dotted lines are there, it means you can't count the number of elements of the set. It's infinite. 1, 2, 3 up to so on with dotted line, but last point is given to you. It means the last value is 100. Means that set is finite. You can count the number of elements. Set of positive integers greater than 100. Greater than 100, you can write any number of items. That's why it's an infinite set. Set of prime numbers less than 99, you can easily count. Because it's less than 99. If this value is greater than 99, you can't count that number. It means the set will become infinite. Similar question is the next question. The set of lines which are parallel to x-axis, it's infinite. You can draw any number of lines which can be parallel to x-axis. Letters in English alphabets, it's finite, you can count. Number of multiples of 5, you can't count these numbers. Means it's infinite. Number of animals living on earth, it is also infinite. You can draw any number of circles with any one point, it's infinite. Now, question number 4. In this question, you have to check whether the sets are equal or not. A, B, C, D, and same elements are there. A, B, C, D, it means sets are equal. 4, 8, 12 and 16, 4, 8, 16 and 18. Elements are different, it means sets are not equal. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. X is a positive even, less than equal to 10. Yes, both the sets are equal. Multiple of 10, it means 10, 20, 30, these are required. But in the set B, 15, 25 is also there. It means sets are not equal. Same criteria is there in question number 5. First elements are 2, 3. X is the solution of the equation. X square plus 5x plus 6. Let us solve this equation. Make the factors. You will get minus 2 and minus 3. It means both the sets are not equal. Second part of question number 5. X such that X is a letter of the word follow. And second is Wolf. It means first set is F, O, L and W. Okay. And second is W, O, L and F. Both the sets are equal. The last question of the exercise. You have to identify which set is equal to which one. Set B is clearly equal to D. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4. And set E is equal to G. Hope you understand the video or contents. In the next video, I will discuss about Venn diagram, union and intersection of the sets, and other representation of the sets using Venn diagram.